In this company, each department uses a specific application tailored to its needs, with its own logic and its own database. The problem is that these different applications were not designed to work together. As a result, we end up with duplicated data in different formats, making it difficult to use the data across various departments' applications. This leads to long processing times and numerous errors due to inconsistencies in the data. This is where the ERP comes in. ERP stands for Enterprise Resource Planning. The goal of an ERP is to ensure the consistency of information and real-time updates within the organization. To achieve this, a set of integrated professional software or applications is used. Each specific department's functions in the organization are covered by a dedicated module within the ERP, such as accounting, sales, procurement, logistics, production, human resources, and so on. The most popular ERPs are SAP ERP, Oracle ERP, and Microsoft Dynamics. The ERP centralizes all the collected data into a single database. This allows the ERP to distribute information more easily and quickly within the organization. For example, if a salesperson records a sale, the ERP will update the company's stock, sales journal, accounting entries, and more in real time. The ERP optimizes processes between various functions of the organization, making it more efficient. Collaboration between different parts of the company becomes not only possible, but also a strategic element for the organization. Now let's differentiate between CRM and ERP, as there is some confusion between the two. As you've seen, an ERP enables centralized management of functions and associated information flows. Among these functions are sales. CRM, on the other hand, is a specialized solution with many features designed to improve sales and, more broadly, customer relations. As we've discussed, the ERP simplifies the information flows within an organization. Thanks to these more reliable and controlled information flows, along with the analysis of key performance indicators, or KPIs, the organization can make strategic decisions more quickly. The aim is to have the information to make the right decisions before your competitors. However, simply implementing an ERP is not enough. A preparatory phase to study the needs is essential to understand what is expected from an ERP. This includes the organization's goals with the ERP, its needs, desired features, a list of potential ERPs, costs, implementation timelines, and more. Furthermore, involving future users from the beginning and throughout the ERP implementation is necessary. Implementing an ERP brings about internal operational changes in an organization. If modules are imposed on users at the end of the ERP implementation, they may be resistant to using them. If you want to keep up with the latest in tech and computer science, don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications. I can't wait to delve into more tech topics with you in our future videos. Goodbye.